God. Thank you.
With the arrival of the Honourable Minister of Interior, Honourable Minister of Interior, Honourable Minister for Foreign Affairs, is Ambassador Gabriel Aduda, the PS to the Minister of Foreign Affairs. The next on the program is the speech by the Controller General.
The Ministry of Foreign Affairs is the happiest today.
Then the back page. This is to one, the glory of God.
And I will hope the Doyen Ambassador would relate this to the rest of the ambassadors through the Minister of Foreign Affairs. I just want to make a little presentation so that we know what we're talking about. Today is the official launch of a temporary passport. And this temporary passport, it is going to be handled by Nigerian diplomatic and consular missions abroad. And it is only issued to Nigerians who are returning to Nigeria. I hope that should be clear. It's not a passport to be issued in Nigeria. It's a document to be issued outside the country. It has what we call a central database. Remember what we had before. All the ambassadors know what we have, what was only a paperwork we're having. But today, we are launching a passport which is going to replace that paperwork we call emergency travel certificate. We call it ETC. I was once at Atachi, who was issuing that ETC in Germany in 1991. So it was just an ordinary paper. But today, there will be a passport. And let me give you the background. I went to the U.S. Embassy in 2017, asking what document they give for returnees, and I studied the temporary passport. Today, this is the result of my visit. It is a document that had challenges. Embassies had complained to us. We too have complaints about the temporary passport because it has no database, no biometric features. It is a huge security threat, that paper, to the host country's authorities and to us. If the British High Commission or the British government is looking for a suspect, he goes to the High Commission and gets a paper with a different name and identity, he will be seen as compromising the security of that country. And we too, we might be looking for a suspect, a Boko Haram suspect, a 419er, a drug trafficker who will return with another identity. That is a challenge we had with the previous document called temporary work passport. So it has become a huge security threat to us and to the global world. That's why today we are launching this document called temporary work passport. It is a document with a blue cover. Remember, all our passports had colors. Red passport for diplomats, green for every Nigerians, red the diplomatic, blue to, today blue is for temporary passport. So please, this document has only 4 pages. It is not going to be a passport with many pages. Our passport has 32 pages, 64 pages. But this document, only 4 pages in it. It has the passport photograph inside, but it is subject to AFIS check. When I say AFIS check, any document we issue, it is centrally controlled. And our AFIS verification is fingerprint. But other part of the world, facial or fingerprint, our verification system is AFIS. So this passport also is AFIS verification. It has chip also, and a surface personalization. Even though you see a passport, that passport has a security chips in it. It contains the data, and we also type the data of the person in the passport. It has enhanced our data system. It means it is connected to our central database, and there is end-to-end connectivity between what is captured and what is in our database. It's just like a passport. So you cannot treat it a separate document. It is passport like other documents. Only issued in missions for one journey return to Nigeria. When I say one journey, it means you cannot return with the passport. If you arrive in Nigeria, you are finished. You won't go back with it. It is only one journey. And I didn't say return journey, I say one journey, which means there could be somebody who doesn't have a passport could start the journey with it and return to Nigeria. But you cannot go back. One journey, travel document. It is also valid for only 30 days from the time it is issued. If it is issued by Canadian High Commission in Ottawa, it is starting to be valid from the day it is issued, but it will expire after 30 days of issue. So, but if it is issued and the person has traveled with it, even within 2 days, but remaining 80 days, it still becomes invalid. So the validity is any issue, anyone that comes last, first, anyone that comes first, 30 days, it will expire. Or when you arrive in Nigeria, it will expire. That's the validity of this document. It also, citizen issued to every citizen of Nigeria, regardless of age. If a child is born today, that child can be given that document to return to Nigeria. So it is for all ages of persons. It automatically invalidates the current passport you reported lost. Which means you arrive, let's say you arrive UK with your Nigerian passport and you declare it lost. Because of that, you are given temporary passport. It invalidated that passport you declared lost. You cannot use it again. This is very important for security so that you don't pick it and go and use it in another place. You have to get it reissued. It will be automatically in the lost and stolen passport document. You can't use it again. This is important. And also, this is what we are using now. I'm sorry to show this sample, but for you to appreciate the changes, we just took a sample at the airport and see the type of emergency travel certificate issued. You can see them. They are different. One coming from UA, one coming from Sudan, one coming from Cairo. Just because different papers, different style. So there is no uniformity. It will be different. This is how this passport we are going to launch looks like. The other one is just exemplars, which we have shared with your missions through Ministry of Foreign Affairs. The exemplars have been issued. To ICAO, it has been issued. And thanks to Mr. President, he has given us approval to establish the PKD and PKI infrastructure. So we'll upload this passport also to the public key directorate of ICAO. That is how it looks like. The front cover, the data page cover, and then the back cover. There will be a page to do endorsement when you pass through the airport. So in conclusion, this document is an investment to our security and to the host country's security. Also, it is a service to Nigerians in emergency situation. Many Nigerians who travel and they find it difficult to return, they can get a document to return. It is also an opportunity for newly born Nigerians. We have a lot of interested cases where Nigerians go and get birth to, in different locations. They would be looking for emergency travel certificate to come back. They can use this passport to come back. If the child arrived in Nigeria, he already has identity. He will have to continue with that identity. He arrived in a temporary passport. It has also a United Prize. I have sent a memo to Minister and he has approved, but I don't want to talk about it. It's, I said, around $60. So it's not expensive to get. So this is my technical presentation, and I thank you, Your Excellency, for listening.